Part of our postgame, our traditional postgame show from Xfinity Center, is Jeff Baxter, who played on some of those great teams with Len Bias and with Lefty Drizel. Jeff, welcome in this evening.
Good evening. Thank you all so much.
Hey, I wanted to get you on for two things. But the first thing is I know that recruiting has changed. And I remember back to the days when Maryland tried to get Moses Malone and then Ralph Sampson, et cetera, and it was a bit more of the Wild West. But are you surprised at the depth of these scandals that have come out, especially what happened in Louisville?
I'll tell you, I'm not surprised actually at the issue itself being what I call, having been what I call the elephant in the room. I think there's always been some existence of some type of quote-unquote steering. But I think I'm really surprised at the fact that the universities that it's associated with, these are high-power universities that are able, just like the University of Maryland, are able to get great players based on the academic and athletic institutions' know-how and their reputation. So I'm surprised at that. If they were schools that are not as high-powered as those two universities, I'm sorry, as those universities that are on task right now or being charged right now or indicted, I wouldn't be surprised.
Well, much like the famous line from Casablanca where Rick said he was shocked that gambling was going on in this establishment, I'm not particularly shocked. I thought things like this were going on. It, to me, the surprising part is it's the FBI who found it. The NCAA didn't find it. The NCAA didn't even know until the FBI went public. But what are you going to do? These things... When somebody shows up at a school and commits the next day after they say they were in love with another school and you wonder how did that happen, it's a little more clear how that happens now.
Yeah. I fully agree with you. I concur with you. And the other interesting thing is that it came about as a result of someone else, the initial person that had gotten caught up for embezzling and some other things. He's the one that I can't think of his name right now. He's the one that actually opened the can of worms to the FBI, and hence it moved forward. And as you said, I'm surprised that the NCAA hadn't caught this or hadn't made any statement prior to regarding this. And you're right, FBI is a whole nother level of issues that's going to come about with the folks
right.
that are involved.
And I know that you know a lot of people on the government side of things, and when they show up, they're not messing around. They have a case. It's not conjecture. They've got the case, and it's already made.
So, exactly.
So that's enough of the bad stuff. Let's take a look at some of the good stuff. Maryland has had three big-time recruits that have come in. They all came in last weekend. Is that right, Mason?
Yes, it is.
And do you remember who they are?
Devin Dotson, a point guard. Eric Ayala, another point guard. And the third one is slipping away, but Moses Brown was there the weekend before. Do you see the Terps being able to land any of these five-star, high-profile guys?
I think so, Mason. I think we have the goods based on the coaching pedigree that was there at Maryland. And now we've added Kevin Brodus, who's from the area, actually, and he has a heck of a recruiting resume. I think we're in a position to land one of those guys. Because if you notice, the Terps do what I call re-up. So after a couple of years, they get another guard in to actually take place of their prior guard, and that's a good thing. That's a resume for success. And if you notice, Cowan came in last year, as a matter of fact, to help with Mello's departure this year. So it's a good thing, and I think we'll get one of the three of those guys.
Yeah, and the third guy that I did not say was Keldon Johnson, and Kevin Brodus actually recruited Keldon Johnson's brother to go play for Georgetown. So that's going to be an interesting development coming through. And Jeff, you were recruited by Maryland at one time. How does it feel to have schools wanting you to come play for them? Because a lot of people haven't had that happen.
Yeah, it's an amazing journey. I visited, when I came out of high school, I visited six schools. And I'll tell you, it's an amazing journey. I think the biggest thing is that you have to, as a player, you have to stay grounded and understand what's best for you, obviously, and your family on the choices that you make. And it has to be something that's aligned with both academia and athletics. And I think very, very important. And these kids coming out of school this day and time, they have to, with the technology they have as far as viewing themselves and viewing and everybody, quote unquote, hyping them up, I think they have to stay grounded and be aware of what's best for them, what fits their game.
Okay, we're up against the clock, but I do have one more for you, and then we're going to have to go to break. Did you know Kevin Broaddus before, and if so, what was the relationship?
Yes, Coach, Kevin and I actually grew up together and played in probably 1,000 leagues throughout the city as we were coming, because he's from the D.C. area as well. So that's how I've known Kevin. He's been the stand-up guy ever since. I can't even think how far back, but he's a stand-up guy. I see him probably every 2 weeks off campus as well, and I run into him. But he was a stand-up guy when he was at Georgetown, and he's a great addition to us at University of Maryland.
All right. Well, we are looking forward to basketball season. We will see you. I know we'll see you for the Butler game, right? That's our first big game at Xfinity Center.
Yes, yes. Actually, you'll see me beforehand. I kind of like to come and look at the guys and kind of check out the chemistry, the body language, all that good stuff. So I'll definitely see you soon.
All right. We'll see you out there. That was Jeff Baxter, former Terp guard. This is Wayne Viener with intern Mason Bruce is away from the microphone. We will be back after these commercial messages.